In 1893, the United States Congress chartered a new university in Washington, D.C., overlooking our nation's capital. This was to be a university founded on a new principle in American education, devoted to service, to preparing men and women to serve their nation, their community, and the wider world. This was to be a university where men and women not only learned the skills and professions by which to live, but also a place to consider those things that make our lives meaningful. This was to be a place where today's leaders helped to shape the leaders of tomorrow, and where the resources of an entire nation helped define the scope of education. Today, that university has surpassed the vision of its founders. That university is the American University in Washington, D.C. From its very beginnings, it has been an institution devoted to the education and preparation for life of all students who want to come here from any part of the world.
I knew I wanted to study in Washington. It was just a matter of deciding where. I'm from a rural area in Arkansas, a very friendly, hospitable area. And so I was looking for that small town atmosphere in the big city. And that's what I found at AU. The people are very friendly. They generally care about you. You're not just a number. You're a face, you're an identity, you're a person. And I like that. It's a good place to go to school.
When I first came, I was scared. I myself was intimidated. And people are friendly. I mean, just sitting in the student center, people come up to you. They actually take the initiative to make friendships here.
I think the people you meet in your dorm, especially on your floor, a lot of them I'll probably keep for life. They're real close. You're living with them. It's not like the same friends you have at home, because you're constantly with them.
Part of Target.
Yes.
Great.
Wow, there's been so many great things that I've done at AU. It's really hard to pinpoint that one thing that's been extra special. It's just been the whole experience of living in Washington and living in an environment where I had a campus, something to really call my own.
It's in the city, but it's not. It's a city campus, but it still has a country to it.
Personally, I wanted three different things. I wanted a campus, and I wanted attention from my professors, and I wanted to be in a great city, and I definitely got all three.
For the party to be lagging behind society, in what ways is it lagging?
Well, he explains that there have been a series of changes in the economy, that social forces have been developing at their own pace, and they need...
I think the way that we do take advantage of Washington, professors encourage you to interact. So you're not just learning what you learn in the classroom, you're learning an experience that'll take you through life.
Lenin not only led to Stalin, but precluded anything but Stalin from emerging from what he left.
And that's a hotly debated issue right now. And there really is no consensus as to how to evaluate the transition from Leninism to Stalinism.
Look, computers cannot feel for you.
See, the professors really stress originality, and they really love it when you're creative.
And you can also express it through the arts, the performing arts, which is what I do. I dance and I act and I sing, and you can choose to do it in art or whatever.
I want classes in a variety of areas, and I think that's going to be beneficial to me as I go through graduate school, as I go through the employment process. I think employers are looking for that. I think graduate programs are looking for that.
That's one way of looking at it. And then the spider and the butterfly and whatnot go on about their business, trying to build a raft so that you can float some way on this poem, and you need the literal base. And I think maybe the first question is, what is really meant by before I leave?
Or what I find in that process is the excitement of what's going on showing people something that maybe I knew before and they now suddenly know, and then they turn the tables and show me something that I just thought of.
Those same students, the ones who have had some literary experience, can every now and then bring us back onto the right track when we begin to get too
experimental with what it is that we're finding.
You're right, that's very important.
When you're an American university, there really is no problem finding any resources that you need.
I use the computer center a lot. It's open 24 hours a day, which is good for me. I usually like to go very early in the morning when there's no one there, and I've never had to wait in a line yet.
Well, I have a computer in my room where I do my word processing, but if I want, I also have the option of hooking it up to the mainframe computer. Of course, I don't spend all my time in front of the computer. There is a huge social life here at AU.
The closeness of the people, I really like that. It's a lot different than a lot of other universities because of that. Everyone seems to be really close and really active, and everyone wants to learn and get involved.
I wouldn't say there really is just one kind of typical AU student. I think it's a very diverse group of people. I mean, AU has almost every kind of college student that I can imagine.
It's fantastic. It's a beautiful neighborhood. There's no crime in this part of the city. And then with our security force on campus and our pass card system for access to the residence halls, we don't have a problem. I can't think of one incident in my years here at AU.
I have two questions. You have let the Bush administration sort of let the Senate and the House collapse in bringing this issue to the foreground. And it seems very odd, it seems very foolish, as simple as those words.
I want to compliment this young man for watching the debate. He obviously watched the debate closely. We're faced with that reality, and it takes two-thirds of both houses to override that veto. And we don't have two-thirds of the vote both houses to do it.
There are so many things to do on this campus. Of course, your classes, but also parties, films, lectures, speakers. You have to decide what's most important, which you have time for.
I'm a communication major. I'm a news person. And when you're a news person, you want to be where the news is being made. And Washington is the political pulse of the nation. And I've made so many great connections. I studied in London for a semester. And I met up with European friends who I met through the university in Europe when I was traveling. I'm going to Argentina this fall for the semester. I'm going to make a stop in Brazil, a stop in Paraguay, a stop in Uruguay, all to visit friends who I've met through the university.
I had a study abroad program, which gave me the opportunity to study in Belgium, work with the development agency, and meet Bishop Tutu all in one semester. And it also has given me the opportunity to further my studies in the workplace. I'll be working in the international relief area of the Department of Energy starting in June.
Being offered a full-time job when she graduated. So it was really wonderful. She got all this experience that was paid.
I think every student should have a chance to see what the world looks like firsthand. And with Joan's abilities, I could see that she could really benefit from that kind of an experience. And with the help of the Career Center, she was able to do that through an internship with the Cooperative Education Program.
My co-op itself was excellent. For that, I have to thank the Career Center and its staff. They give you a lot of guidance. And it helped me to find what turned out to be a perfect co-op for me with the Academy for Educational Development on their Botswana project.
Last year, I had an internship at the Organization of American States, which is a regional organization that's part of the UN. And each week I went downtown and I worked in the Department of Cultural Affairs. I came here, I really didn't know what I wanted, what I was interested in, and from taking classes and through my experience on campus and in the city, I've really learned what type of person I am and what I enjoy doing that I think is really going to help me in the future.
I think if I sit there on graduation day, I'm going to know that AU has helped me find out what I want to do with my life. I think more than anything else, being a part of this university has taught me the idea of service and community. And so I know that when I'm doing something, I can't just do it for myself. I have to do it for others also.
What is to be gained by the university experience? Knowledge, certainly, but perhaps more important, wisdom, openness to the world, a respect for differences, a search for understanding, and a commitment to quality in all that we do. These have defined the history and the traditions of the American university. For education involves more than reading books. It involves the heart, will, and commitment.
For more information, call or write Office of Admissions and Financial Aid, 4400 Massachusetts Avenue Northwest, Washington, D.C.